shooting of a 10-year-old boy.
This happened around 1 this afternoon at the Warren Manor Apartments on DeQuinder in Warren. The boy was shot in the chest and rushed to a hospital where he later died. Police say there were 10 children in the apartment at the time, ages ranging from 5 to 17. Let's bring in Jason Colthorpe. He's live at that apartment complex with the latest information. Jason.
Kim, we're still trying to figure out how many of those 10 kids belonged here, how many are related, how many were supposed to be living here. However many it is, we know they won't be living here anymore. The complex came out earlier tonight, a few hours ago, and changed the locks on this apartment. As for that 15-year-old, we're told he turned himself into police around 6 o'clock tonight. Warren police have now spoken to everyone involved in the death of a 10-year-old boy at Warren Manor Apartments this afternoon. 7 juveniles and 1 17-year-old girl left the station tonight after being questioned. All were in the apartment with the 15-year-old alleged shooter and the victim. There were no adults.
That's nothing new for kids to do or parents to have happen in their house. You know, every parent has that happen in their house, man. So that's nothing wrong with that, you know, but they shouldn't have been playing with the gun.
I'm pretty sure they was in there trying to make a video with the guns, all that gang stuff. It's not for children. None of this is for nobody.
Neighbors had complained about that apartment and the unattended children several times.
And I tried to tell them about all these parties and fighting and everything, but to know a gun just went off right next to my apartment, across from my apartment, it makes me feel uncomfortable.
An employee of Warren Manor told me they tried to call the renter just yesterday to issue another warning, but got no answer.
That child should have never lost his life. He's a child. Like, this is really sad. I'm really trying not to get emotional. This is really sad, you know?
It's the second fatal shooting here in 8 months, and this young mother now thinks her best option is to leave after what happened.
Yeah, he had a lot of life to live. He had to, you know, go to college, you know, at least do something in life to grow up, you know? You didn't know what that boy wanted to do. You didn't know? He's a baby.
Yeah. Now police still focusing on this investigation. A lot of questions, obviously. Where were the parents, number one, and was this accidental? They're still looking into that. As for where were the parents, neighbors say they rarely saw them except when there was a party going on, and kids were often coming and going. We'll have to wait and see when they present the case to prosecutors. We expect tomorrow. Kimberly, back to you.
Yeah, and I know it's still early in the investigation, Jason. A lot we don't know, but are police saying anything about possible charges against the parents in this case?
Well, they're not ruling it out for sure. They say that's very possible, as well as they keep going in this when they figure out who it was. And also about who owned this gun, because the gun was recovered here. Once they get into all that, more charges could be coming down the line.
Certainly more to come. Okay, Jason, thanks.